I gotta find a safe place to stop down for the night. With daylight fading fast, speed is of the essence.
Having lost Joel, and with night approaching, the UAV returns to base to be fueled and prepped for relaunch come morning.
We gotta get out, get down into the canyon, find some place to set up for the night.
When you lose the light, you lose the shine. You know, light gives us the ability to see things. The reflection off of the ground spore, aerial spore, etc. So at night, you lose it. You can track using white light, green light, red light, or night vision, but you gotta weigh it. If we're out here moving around and we illuminate our position or we come up close, he's gonna see it. And from there, he'll take off running.
I've just found my campsite. I've got soft ground here with a lot of insulating material that's gonna keep me from the earth, because it's gonna get really, really cold tonight. I'm gonna set up some sort of early warning system around my campsite. I'm gonna tie some lines across points of entry so I can see them approach if they're tracking me at night. And if somebody's coming up on me, they're gonna hit it with some part of their body and snap that pretty easily, make a loud, dry snapping noise. And I will definitely, definitely hear that. Now I gotta go find something to eat.
Neither Joel nor Phantom Recon know that they have set up camp just 300 meters away from each other, separated by just a ridgeline. However, since Joel carries no rations, he must leave the safety of his campsite to find food in the dark.
This is prickly pear cactus. It's edible. And right now I'm down for anything that's edible. I can have something to eat. Prickly pear has these little patches of small, hairy spines. If they get in my mouth or even in my hands, I'm gonna be feeling it.
I've been going for 18 hours. And tomorrow's gonna be rough.
Pretty clean, still being really careful. And there's dinner. Except for the veins, it's actually really tasty. Now to get some shut eye.
With his dinner complete, Joel makes his way back to his camp. Meanwhile, Phantom Recon sets up a night patrol, looking and listening for any sign of Joel, knowing he was last seen just 400 meters from their current position.
We're setting up a patrol base. We're gonna hold this position.
Which enables us to rest and conduct patrol base operations.
Military advisor Peter Kerr sets a wide perimeter with a radius of 365 meters. And Joel, returning to his campsite, has just unwittingly crossed it.
Roger, let me grab my pen.
Towards it and then get into a fixing position.
Getting really close, but I can't move. All I can do is stay put.
The Hunter force is now within 15 meters of Joel.
Did you hear that?
Yeah. Having no idea how close they were to Joel, the Phantoms regroup, giving Joel an opening.
gotta get out of here. Get back to my campsite.
Joel retreats 300 meters south to his campsite, giving him the protection and cover of the ridgeline.
There's only a few people, and you think about who we're pursuing. This dude's in shape. I mean, no joke. He's in shape. Look, hauled ass up that hill. He's applying the right skill sets. His anti-tracking was good. This is somebody that's highly trained. He may have already passed through. If he has, we'll get on it, and we'll start running. All right, that's all we got. Nice. Get the coffee in the morning.
The advantage that the Phantoms now have, like any hunting force, is well-stocked supplies. They have fire, rations, and safety in numbers.
He's out there with probably no water at this point, eating whatever grubs he can pull out from the ground. The boy's got to be hurting. You guys pushed him hard.
I guarantee you he's tired.
Yeah. And we still got tomorrow morning?
Yep, right on.
Is that Indian country?
It is really, really cold. And it's only going to get colder before the sun comes back up. So I'm going to do something I ordinarily never would do, which is light a fire. Because now it's a matter of survival. All right, so got a good flat rock.
I've pulled a 9-volt battery from my emergency strobe light and some steel wool from my pilot's kit.
It's an electrical charge, a 9-volt battery.
When the steel wool touches the terminals on the battery, electrical current flows through the really thin wires of the steel wool, and the wires get really hot really fast.
There we go. Matches or lighters can get wet or fail, but this is more reliable.
I've minimized the risk of being spotted by building the fire in a low-lying area, and I'm concealed by thick tree cover all the way around.
All right, I have a fire. My parachute silk is gonna come in real handy right now. I'll be able to just tie the bottom together. This is gonna keep the air that my body heats trapped inside and not escaping out the bottom. I'm trying to keep this parachute material as enclosed as possible so I don't lose any heat out from any cracks. Let my body heat warm up this cavity as much as possible. Oh, it's a long night. I know those guys are gonna move out at first light, so I don't wanna be out of here way before that. I'm not gonna give them the opportunity to catch me laying down. I gotta get moving.
Got a really horrible trek ahead of me with a lot of elevation, so I'm dumping everything that I'm not gonna need so I can make the best time I can up this mountain. It's just barely light enough for me to move, but still too dark for them to track effectively. So I'm trying to make time while I can.
But the Phantoms are already up and planning their attack.
Back in there where we did the IED lanes when we parked, they're gonna go up onto that ridge.
He's expected to be around here.
If he does go this way, we wanna push him over this. We don't wanna let him take any of these easy routes.
Yeah.
That's kind of the intent here, is push him up one of the hills.
Just
whatnot.
Smoke his ass.
Let's start moving. The way they can move up.
As the sun comes up an hour later, Phantom Recon splits into two teams and moves out.
The hunger pains are fading, but I can feel that I'm really not thinking too clearly. I gotta be really careful right now. It's warming up out here now. Or maybe I'm just getting the blood moving from that cold night on the ground.
As Recon 2 moves up the ridge, Sergeant Overway and Recon 1 discover just how close they were to their target.
We were that fucking close all night. He spent the night here. He was able to start a fire. We're not sure what he had to start it.
Where he had a fire, and he had it all blocked off so he couldn't see the light from too far away. He knew what he was doing.
As Recon 1 processes Joel's camp and looks for spore, Joel has already moved 1.6 kilometers up the ridge, but still has the same distance to go to reach his extraction point.